As the commentator for Ebony Fashion Fair, I communicate with people all day long. I go to 180 cities worldwide. My schedule is crazy, insane. We're on stage, we're doing what we do, and just being free-flowing and, you know, not so constricted that you can't have fun.
All right, new research showed that high school girls who are underweight or who think of themselves as overweight might be at an increased risk of engaging in unsafe sexual behavior.
And the details were really scary with this new report. Those girls with a low body mass index, BMI, didn't use condoms as much either. And those with a high BMI were more likely to have sex before 13.
Anyway, here to help us understand this disturbing trend is teen life coach Jada Collins. Hello, Jada.
Hey there.
What is going on? It's
really scary, but when you look at it, the truth is it's just low self-esteem.
I think you're right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's poor body concept, and we got to get to the root of it. And when you think about it, you look at poor body image.
Yeah.
And then you go to low self-esteem. And then you go, why do you have that? And you have to look at three areas when you were looking at that. First of all, it could definitely be abuse. And that's really serious. Something we have to take a look at. Then it can also be the relationships that they have with their parents or with other people, their friends. And then at the end of the day, it goes back to my favorite thing that I like to talk about. That funny thing of our thought process.
Yeah.
It's getting in there, kind of figuring out what's going on with the way that you're thinking.
Mm-hmm.
And we really got to take a look at what's happening with our teens today.
Well, you know, my concern is that there's some girls or even guys, too, that are just genetically born to be overweight or look overweight or stocky or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And those
big
are the
bone.
Ones, big bone, if you want to call it. Exactly. And, you know, how do we have those kids that are maybe genetically that way or just, you know, they become overweight to actually still have that self-esteem by yet telling them, hey, you need to get in shape.
Right.
You know that thin line?
Right. And it goes back to another thing, balance. It's trying to figure out, you know, how much is too much and then how much is natural. Sometimes some of us are naturally thin, like I am just naturally thin, and then you have those who are naturally, like you call it, big bone.
Big bone.
I wish I could use that excuse. I just eat too much.
Which is it, Mitch? You're just a big bone or just eat too much.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? Here it is. The acronym for LEAD, listen. It's really important for parents to listen. Get in there, ask them questions, find out what they're thinking and what they're going through. And then after that, we have to empathize. We have to look at ourselves and say, hey, what's going on with myself and how can I help them and how can I empathize? Affirm. We need to give them affirmation and teach them how to feel good about themselves. And finally, direct. We need to direct them and get them the help that they need. If they need to go and see a counselor, if they need to deal with some of the maladaptive behaviors through the thought process, then we need to do that.
Awesome stuff there, Jada. Thank you so much. And for more information, head on over to our website, dailybuzznow.com.